May kasabihan na hindi kaya ng isang star player na buhatin ang kanyang buong kupunan. Kadalasan, kailangan niya ng isang ever-reliable na sidekick tulad ni na Pippen para kay Jordan, si Kobe para kay Shaq, or si Shaq para kay Kobe, that's up to you to decide, at si Stockton para kay Malone. Ang ongoing NBA season naman ngayon, sino ba ang best second banana o sidekick? Para sa usapan na yan, kasama natin ang basketball blogger na si Nico Baguio. Nico, welcome back to the Score.
Always great to be
good
here.
To see you. Did you bring any bananas to compare?
Nagutom tuloy ako.
Nagutom ka tuloy. Our second banana queue, okay? Whatever we want to call it. Pero it's interesting that we brought up some of those examples, the Pippen to the Jordan, the Stockton to the Malone. The Shaq and the Kobe, very debatable for the Shaq and the Kobe fans.
Yeah.
Pero sa'yo, unahin natin yung definition mo ng second banana para maliwanag sa mga fans. Ano bang second banana para sa'yo?
Yeah, second banana when people ask me who the second banana of a team is. Usually, my answer is the second best player on that team.
Okay.
And if they're equally talented, like for example, nga yung Kobe and Shaq, the question becomes who sets the tempo for the team.
Okay.
So, kung sino yung nagsiset ng tempo, siya yung technically alpha ng team.
Right.
Not necessarily siya yung pinakamagaling or clear number one.
Though. Okay. All right. And it's not in absolute number of stats, because the second banana could be like the best defender.
Yeah, definitely.
And he has such
definitely.
A value that he's the second most valued player.
Yeah,
ba?
definitely.
Okay, so that's the groundwork that we have. So meron po kami pinining lima. I'm sure you might have a different set of five, na top five. Ito yung medyo pinag-agreehan namin ni Nico at ng aming producer na napakatalino at napaka kahanga-hanga. Let's not name him as named Paul Loyola. But anyway, first off, this guy who scored 51 points the other day that shocked a lot of people with what he was able to do with the Washington Wizards, Bradley Beal. Yeah, na medyo maliwanag na John Wall's always been first banana and he's second banana. How good is Bradley Beal and how valuable is he to this Wizards team?
Well, I think the biggest change sa game ni Beal for the last 2 years is yung ability niya to pull up from three and from mid-range. Dati kasi he didn't have that in his repertoire. Mm-hmm. So he was very limited as a just as a off-screen shooter and straight line driver kapag ano. Ngayon, he can be involved in pick and rolls now.
Mm-hmm.
So what happens is that nag-expand yung lane just because of yung threat ng pull-up niya. And I think that's expanded Beal's influence and impact on a game just from that small development in his game.
Right. Well, and interestingly enough, this game that he scored 51 points, partly, wala kasi si John Wall.
Yeah.
He's still injured. He had the green light to go berserk, and he did. Pero yun nga, pinakita niyo yung kanyang full repertoire ng kanyang skill set. And when you saw the highlights of that game and you saw his, you know, how he did it, convinced ka na he's really up the notch in terms of being that good of a player for the Wizards.
Yeah, and that's a good thing about having a second banana is that when your first banana, I don't know why we're using it.
Banana, but main star, okay.
When your second, when your primary star is out, you have that secondary star to rely on, and that's what Beal did for the Wizards. He scored 51 points, and he was able to stop the bleeding for the Wizards because they've been losing games the past week or so. And I think yung 51 points ni Beal was parang a revelation for everybody.
Right. Well, isa pang magandang silbi ng isang second banana, lalo na kung similar style, similar value in the court, is that when one rests, the other one is in. And we showed this, we talked about this right before we got on the air, CP3 to the James Harden, to the beard. Na marami nagtaka at the start of the, before the season started, nung sumama si CP3, how is this gonna work?
Yeah.
The two of them are very ball dominant, heavy guards. One is a, you know, converted to a point guard. One is the point god, di ba? Pero anong nakikita mo so far? He's not even 100% yet. He's coming back after injury. But they're still winning and they're doing quite well. So CP3, anong value niya ngayon sa Rockets for you?
I think makikita ng mga tao dito yung effect ng actually ng isang magaling na point guard talaga. Because if you're looking at just Chris Paul's numbers, I think he's averaging 13 points, about 9 assists, and then very poor percentages. Pero his team is around plus 16 when he's on the court. And even without James Harden, I think pag wala si James Harden, it's plus 30 pa.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, and I think yun yung biggest thing with having similar players be parang first and second stars mo.
Right.
For the Houston Rockets, they have two ball dominant players na parang people were wondering how they would fit. Pero what happens is that although they are not 100% right now when they play together, it's when one is on the court without the other where they flourish and 100% sila parate. Correct. They're always good. Correct. Wala silang minutes sa court na hindi magaling yung team nila. Correct. And correct. I think that's the great thing about the Houston Rockets right now.
Nandun yung dalawang proven leader palagi. One of them is always there who can lead the team, run the offense,
run the offense, get points, get people back buckets when they need it.
Galeng, galeng. So that's how dangerous this Houston Rockets team is. Imagine more if they can really figure things out
when they play together.
Coming to the playoffs. And by the way, the number one team in the league. So,
hindi po
biro itong Rockets ito. Okay, Paul George, here's an interesting second banana because all his life, he was number one banana. You know, he was like the man in Indiana. And in his desire to be in a more competitive team, to be with a contender, he's now the second or some might even argue the third banana if you want to make, say, Melo is higher than him or whatever. But clearly, he's not above Russell Westbrook, who's the main banana, the reigning MVP. Kamusta naman yung pag-fit in ni Paul George sa role niya ng supporting cast? Just safe to say, para kay Westbrook sa OKC.
Yeah, George for me is the perfect secondary star in the NBA. He's not good enough to carry a team right now. I think he, since nung leg injury niya, he hasn't been the same as a isolation scorer, which is important for a wing first play. Parang kung siya yung magiging main scorer mo, he has to be good in isolation.
Right,
and
right.
I think there's been a dip over the last 2 years. Mm-hmm. But the good thing about George is that he's good at everything.
Yeah.
He's literally the definition of a jack of all trades. Mm-hmm. You want him to come off screens, he can shoot.
Yeah.
Spot up, that's good.
Yep.
Pick and roll, that's good.
Yep.
He can even post up smaller guards. And when you want him to defend, he can defend wings, quick guards, strong guards,
even the stretch force.
Some stretch force, right? So I think, Paul George has fit in really well with Oklahoma, even though yung shots niya, they're not falling in as frequently as they in compared to career numbers.
Yep.
But I think Paul George has fit in perfectly with the Oklahoma
Thunder. The effectivity is there. I mean, not necessarily look at the wins and losses. Obviously, the Thunder are not happy where they are in terms of the record, but in terms of, you know, how he fits in that role.
Yeah, and yung comfort level niya dun sa team. It's like he was able to transition really well into being just that secondary star from being the primary star in Indiana a season before.
Hindi tulad ng nangyari kay LeBron and Dwayne Wade when they first teamed up.
Yeah.
It was awkward
for
a whole year.
Yeah, it was really awkward for like a couple of months.
Yeah, correct. Okay, to the Eastern Conference we go, the number one team in the East, the Boston Celtics. Al Horford is now second banana because Gordon Hayward is still out. But of course, flat earth boy Kyrie Irving is number one banana there. But yeah, dahil wala nga si Gordon Hayward, Horford has become by default the second best player there. And again, another one of those guys that it's not necessarily the points, it's just the overall impact. The guy, he gives good screens, he can flash at the basket, pull in the defense, all these different things. They're playing so well. How good is Brad Stevens in maximizing Horford as that secondary star?
Yeah, watching, the Celtics are my favorite team to watch right now. Mm-hmm.
Aside from the Pelicans. Let's get that in there.
Aside from the Pelicans. because of Al Horford.
Yeah.
He's the engine that makes the offense and defense run, even though Kyrie is the one that draws the most from the defense. Because the good thing about Horford is that even though his numbers are below a normal star.
Yep. Not during his All-Star days in Atlanta.
Yeah, not a 2010, like a regular 2010 guy. Oh. But I think his impact is there. Kasi he's the one that... I really love the actions of the Celtics when they sort of do that give and go.
Mm-hmm.
Parang Kyrie passes to Horford and then a quick cut for Kyrie and then Horford can find him for a for a pass in the paint. And that wouldn't happen if Horford wasn't there. If Horford wasn't as good of a passer
and a threat to score himself,
of a shooter, that wouldn't open up for Kyrie. And that's why the Celtics have been so fun. They've been so good at leveraging Horford's passing into a although mediocre offense, a still fun offense to watch.
Right. Now, last but not the least of our arguable top five, we can't not mention this guy. Dahil nga, maliwanag na maliwanag, favorite team po ni Nico Baguio, ang New Orleans Pelicans, him and just, I think, two other human beings in the Philippines. But Boogie Cousins, okay, when he came in from that trade last year, it was an exciting time for the Pelicans. It was a challenge to fit them in, the Twin Towers. Still is a challenge a bit, no? Pero, kamusta yung role na to? I mean, this is one of those arguable ones na parang pantay. You can't say one is really over the other. Yeah. But just for discussion's sake, if because clearly Anthony Davis is the franchise player, nauna siya doon. Yeah. So just say by first come, first serve basis, second banana si Boogie. Pero how good is he complementing Anthony Davis and making this team better as a whole when these two click?
I think the good thing about Boogie is that si Davis kasi, I really like the definition that AD isn't the engine of an offense. Mm-hmm. He can't be the focal point of an offense. Okay. But he can be the sharpest spear. Parang siya yung, he's the one doing the most damage, mm-hmm. even though he doesn't do all of the creating.
Okay.
And I think the presence of Boogie, who's a better creator than Anthony Davis, has mm-hmm. opened up AD's game. Actually, AD's average shooting the most efficient so far season of his career. Mm-hmm. And that's saying a lot from a guy that shooting 50% and averages a true shooting percentage of around 57%.
Wow.
Yun yung biggest thing about having Boogie beside AD. And right now, AD's injured, mm-hmm. but and Boogie has risen to that franchise level. Kasi yun nga, as you said, parang technically when you look at them, they're parang 1A and 1B rather mm-hmm. than A and B or 1 and 2.
Yep.
So I think, yun nga, when people ask me who's the best second banana, mm-hmm. for me, it's Boogie kasi he can be a franchise yep. player for another team. It's just that Davis is on his team.
Right, right. And he's seemingly accepted that role.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, his ego was
well
able
with
to take
team.
It, yeah. which worried a lot of people.
Yeah, yeah, even me.
Ego. Yeah, I'm sure. Kung matitake ba ng ego ni Boogie. And so far, so good.
So far, so good.
Okay, well, before I ask you your fearless forecast of, aside from Boogie, the top four, who's the best second banana, let's go for some honorable mentions. Let's listen down. Probably, you can't not talk about the Cavs. They're the number two team now in the East, 13 straight wins. Kevin Love, it's been 3 years that he's been there, and he used to be third banana because of Kyrie Irving. But with Isaiah Thomas not yet there, so much demand for him to score, and lalo na nung nag-struggle pa si Dwayne Wade, with D-Rose out as well. Opportunity to score really was there for Kevin Love.
Yeah, pero his role is really more like LeBron is the one, and mm-hmm. then Kevin is still like the third.
Right.
Just because there's no two there.
Right.
He's
okay.
moving up.
Uh-oh.
Pero yung role niya, it's still the same. He still spots up when LeBron is on the court.
Mm-hmm.
And when he's off the court, when he's on the court without LeBron, dun siya nakakuha nung similar post-up situations niya from Minnesota 4 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Pero in terms of role, I think Kevin Love is still a third banana.
But a very effective one.
Yeah,
effective
very, very good third banana.
All right. And just one fun second banana to talk about because they're another fun team to watch. The 76ers, Ben Simmons, where a lot of people are already comparing could be just skills-wise and height and length.
Yeah,
could be like a LeBron.
Yeah.
So fun to watch.
So fun.
With Joel Embiid there as well. Clearly, Embiid is the franchise player of the process.
But
how good is a Ben Simmons and how good can he still be? And does he need to be a second banana? Can he even be better than Embiid eventually?
Yeah, Embiid and Simmons can be that scary 1A, 1B that...
Like a Shaq Kobe.
Yeah, like a Shaq Kobe that fit in really well with the modern NBA.
Yeah.
Embiid can shoot from outside. Simmons can't.
But
Simmons doesn't need to.
Doesn't
like,
need to, exactly.
Even, parang yung nangyayari lang kay Giannis ngayon.
Mm-hmm.
They don't need the jumper because they're so long, they're so strong, and they're so fast for their size that their vision opens up a lot of lanes that are normally not there. Like, when you watch now, actually, when you watch the defense play the 76ers and Ben Simmons, they're playing him for the pass now.
Mm-hmm.
That's why he's scoring a little bit more now compared to dun sa start ng season. And that's where yung potential ni Ben Simmons comes in, where he's able to balance scoring and passing. And that's so scary, especially for a guy that's hasn't turned 21 yet.
Grabe, no?
Yeah.
Grabe. Yep. And ambidextrous. not amphibious, but ambidextrous. Kalipat kanan. All right. Well, without the Boogie Cousins, who is your default number one pick? And the way I've heard you answer, let's take out Beal. Pili ka. PG, CP3, Horford. Sino talaga ang the best second banana?
Yeah, I think I answered it. It's PG. Most overall.
Swak na swak,
yeah, swak na swak siya sa modern NBA. And yung role niya and yung abilities niya, it fits really well into that second secondary role to Russell Westbrook.
Well, reminds you a lot of Scottie Pippen as well.
Yeah.
Alrighty. Well, Nicks, maraming salamat. Fun to chat with you again. Kung may gusto kayong magdebate, awayin dyan sa mga pinili niya. He's at Nico Baguio on Twitter. Salamat, Nicks.
Hi guys, keep watching The Score for the latest sports updates and don't forget to subscribe to the ABS-CBN Sports in Action YouTube channel.